everyone. I'm Yongjin Hamo, and today I'm going to be talking on a short presentation on Shojun Nawanambil and his dispute over the true reincarnation of Kingyun Pema Karpo. Following the death of Kingyun Pema Karpo in 1952, the two candidates were claimed to be the reincarnation of Kingyun Pema Karpo. And these two candidates are Park Seong-bo and Nawanambil. So, now let's talk on Park Seong-bo. Park Seong-bo was born in 1593. Born at Chung in Zhang province, and he is the illegitimate son of Naung Sonam Jakpa and the elder cousin of 5th Dalai Lama. Let's now talk on Shabjung. As we all know much on Shabjung, I'll just brief on it. Shabjung's birth was prophesied by Lord Buddha in Sutra and Tantra. In Gimpo Nidup Jungwa, the Buddha stated, "There will appear a Vajra Acharya, equal to Trinity, and who will conquer the demon." And Guru Rinpoche also stated that, "There will appear a man called Dudum Dorji, a lord of mystery." Shabjung was conceived to his mother's womb. His mother dreamt of a golden Vajra entering her womb. Even and after the birth of Shabjung Nawanambil, Shabjung was safely guarded by Yishi Genpo and Pelton Hamo. Pema Karpo also promised Myeham Tepi Nima that he will be reborn as his son. As prophesied, Shabjung was born to Yap Tepi Nima and Yum Sonam Pelki in 1594 at Druk Ranung Monastery. Let's now talk of what is Drukpa lineage. Kelung Drukpa is a honorary title of the head of the Drukpa lineage, one of the independent Sarma new schools of Vajrayana Buddhism. This lineage of reincarnated masters started from Sampajori, the first Kelung Drukpa and the founder of the school. The tall Kelung Drukpa, Jimmy Pema Wangchen, is the current lineage holder. He was born at Lake Rewasa in India in 1963. Now let's talk about the supporters of the two candidates. Firstly, Park Seong-bo was supported by Hatik Nawang Sampo, was the influential follower of Kelung Drukpa Karpo, and one of the most monks of Joshi Tongmen and Druk Sangha Chuli Monastery supported the Hatik Nawang Sampo's nephew Park Seong-bo. Nawanambil was supported by Gyal clan and Ralung Monastery, the traditional seat of Drukpa school, and their supporter claimed on behalf of Nawanambil the decision ultimately led to the decision by Karma Vinson Nambil. Hatsiwa and the supporters of Churin Depa conducted interment ceremony for Park Seong-bo at Deshi Chongmen Monastery, where he thus appointed as the sixth new Gyalung Drukpa and supposed incarnation of Kingyun Pema Karpo. The Chuin Daejeon then convinced Tsang Daisy, or the Daepa Tsangpa, being the patron of the rival Karma Kaji sect, to support the recognition of Park Seong-bo. By the 16th Sol, Karma Vinson Nambil had become the major political force in central Tibet, and his words carried a great weight.
The relation between Nawang Nambil and the Daisy deteriorated. Nawang Nambil requested the Tsang Daisy to determine Pema Karpo's true incarnation, but the Daisy ignored his request. The two then met at Shigata Zong, but the meeting failed to bring a solution to the dispute. On their way back to Ralong, Nawang Nambil and his men became entangled in a dispute with the retreat of one of the lamas from Karmapa Sect at the ferry crossing at the river of Tsangpo. Unfortunately, some of the lamas' men drowned when their yakskin boat capsized. The lama, who was the supporter of Tsang Daisy, filed a court case against the Nawang Nambils. The judgment passed was that Nawang Nambil would have to pay a fine for the dead and hand over the special relic called Rangjung Khasak Pani, which was preserved at Druk Ralung Monastery. This clearly indicated that Tsang Daisy openly supported Park Seong-bo. Nawang Nambil, however, refused to abide the terms of the court. Daisy was imprisoned and began to preparations for an attack on the Ralung Monastery. Nawang Nambil had sometimes decided to leave for Bhutan or Mongolia, in Bhutan where he had many disciples. His decision was supported by several prophecies. One morning, he was found sight of a bundle of paddy, although nobody from Bhutan had sometime visited him. This he presumed a good omen for favoring his wish to leave for the south. One night, he had a vision of a protective deities, Yishi Genpo Mahakala and Pelton Hamo Mahakali, offering him the valleys of Bhutan. He also dreamt the black raven of emanation of Yushigimpu flying towards his southern. All of these omens only had one implication. Nawang Namgyal would have to go to Bhutan, where his forefather has built numerous monasteries and followers. So bye-bye, guys. Don't forget to subscribe to this history channel and like this video and wait for the next video from my friends, which will be exciting and educational.